Weather calms down for us for once after a couple active weeks in a row where we had at least one big storm come through. We have some sunshine returning tomorrow, so again, calm conditions ahead, but that weather is going to remain chilly. We've got some pretty bitter wind chills coming in the morning. Later this week, we do have some warmth returning, but that does come with the next weather maker, which will bring rain showers. So thankfully, we're warm enough for that. I'm not talking snow or ice this time around this week. And the sunshine, a welcome sight. If you're feeling a little sluggish after the time change this weekend, it's a good way to help adjust the body clock. Getting out into that sunny weather, especially during the morning, may help you feel less tired after the switch that we just had from daylight saving time. So try to enjoy the sunshine as much as you can, but layer up if you are going to be out. That's the double-edged sword with this, is that we're down to 15 degrees for a low tonight. That does mean single-digit wind chills in the morning. So yes, we have the clear weather. Might be enjoyable to get out in the sun, but just make sure you're layering up, especially during those morning hours, because of the bitterly cold conditions that we'll have for those first few hours of the morning. Now, tomorrow is Pi Day, named after the mathematical constant, which is the ratio between the circumference and the diameter of a circle. So that's always 3.14. In March 14th. So for the math nerds out there, it's a little holiday to celebrate going into tomorrow. And of course, we can see all sorts of circles in the weather all around us in the sky. Now, when it comes to our forecast, we are looking at only 35. So it's just barely above freezing under that bright sunny sky. Thankfully, winds stay light. So again, we have the harsh wind chills, but not looking at the bite to the wind like we had today with those breezy conditions. Later this week, warm enough for rain. We could see some hefty totals, up to about an inch of rainfall or so. So enough to really soak the area from sunup to sundown as we go into Thursday. Here we are Thursday afternoon, and that's when a lot of the rain really starts to get going. It might be drizzly in the morning, but here's the bulk of the showers coming through on the tail end of Thursday. So mid-afternoon, we're seeing the rain start up, and it's just going to continue for a while. They're going into Thursday evening, as you can see here, Thursday night into Friday morning, still raining across their area. May get a couple snowflakes mixing in on the backside of this next weather system as the weather cools back off again. So we do warm up 35 for tomorrow, but near 50 for Wednesday and Thursday. Then we drop back down again. Could be near freezing for the start of the weekend, just like we had this past weekend. We do warm up a little faster, though, maybe back into the mid-40s, just in time for the official start of the spring season. And your most accurate 10-day forecast could even be warmer from there. So just in time for spring to start, we could be looking at the low 50s and rain going into next week. So there are signs of spring on the horizon. They just might take a while to get here. For today, hit the bullseye on the 4-degree guarantee. That means the cash total is near $200. We see if we can go over that mark as we go into tomorrow.